Hello, my friends. So, that for several years I have been proposing that classic Darwinian evolutionary theory needs to be challenged, that consciousness guides evolution. So, today I was actually very thrilled to see an article, and this article has just appeared in a journal called Progress in Biophysics and Molecular Biology. Let me read directly from the article. An interesting paper this month at Progress in Biophysics and Molecular Biology argues not only that living cells are cognitive, that is, in some sense, they think, but their thinking is the basis, but that their th thinking is the basis of evolution. The first part of the claim is not new. In 2021, molecular biologist James Shapiro told his colleagues that all living cells are cognitive. What's new is that scientists working from this perspective have begun to develop a detailed theory of evolution that squarely challenges Darwin's natural selection, quote unquote, survival of the fittest. Darwinian natural selection, the theory exclusively taught in schools in many places, states that natural selection, acting on random mutation of genes, accounts for the history of life. And this new group thinks that cognition, as present even in earliest living cells, does so. Quote unquote. I'm so happy to read this. The argument is now advanced that the concept of natural selection should also be comprehensively reappraised. Cognitive science is presented as a more precise term, better suited to 21st century biology. Since cognition began with life's origin, natural selection represents cognitive selection. Biology in the 21st century, natural selection is cognitive selection, according to these scientists. They view natural selection as a tautology that explains nothing and predicts nothing. One might add that it adapts well to slogans that can be boomed from the front of a room, silencing dissent. For many years, that seems to have been enough. But then we started to learn more about selves. The authors propose cognition-based evolution instead of cognition is coincident with life's origin, and what has been termed natural selection should instead be considered cognitive selection. Yes, they go all the way back to the origin of life with mats of cells engaged in cooperative behaviors and collaborative problem solving. Quote unquote. No one knows how cognition began. However, there's no reason to doubt that whatever that spark, cognition was epitomized in the cellular form, approximately 3.7 to 3.4 billion years ago, and that intelligence has been governing the flow of biological information continually since then, thereafter. Darwinian theory holds that evolution is neither purposeful nor goal-oriented, but they argue the measured use of information by discriminating cells yields purposeful cellular actions as coordinated biological expressions whose goal is cell-derived niche constructions representing cell-based solutions to environmental stresses. The assertion that the origin of life corresponds with the origin of cognition and sentience consciousness has been codified and supported as the cellular basis of consciousness. Well, I disagree. The cell itself is an expression of consciousness. Anyway, simply put, all cells have been conscious, cognitive, sentient agents since life began, as bacteria and archaea. Not surprisingly, Miller et al. Have little use for the popular view that cells are living machines. CBE begins with the foundation that cognitive cells engage in the self-referential reception, assessment, communication, and deployment of information. Accordingly, cells are competent problem-solving, intelligent agents that make contingent self-referential decisions, completely unlike all programmed machines. Cells engineer their environments. Then it goes on to say there's a form of panpsychism, and I personally don't, subscribe to panpsychism. I subscribe to non-dualism, although panpsychism is a compromise. Okay, CBE is the new term, cellular basis of consciousness, a form of panpsychism. I think we now need to go beyond panpsychism to understand the consciousness-only monism model. In any case, this article is out now, and well, finally, Darwinian evolution is being challenged. So it seems, a long time ago, 2012 or something like that, that I made the case for consciousness guiding evolution. I was in India, and the newspapers carried the headline with great ridicule. But see, slowly our understanding is evolving, that consciousness is the fundamental reality shaping evolution. Finally, you can also, by the way, get digital dharma if you so wish, if you have the time, ability, desire, to see how AI can elevate spiritual intelligence and personal well-being. And actually check the validity of this article through any search engine AI that you have access to. And you can also engage with me or my digital twin now by going to digitaldeepak.ai. Thank you, my friends.